Muslim deserves to get beating. He says that the non-Muslims accuse Islam that he permits the husband to beat his wife. And is that true? And who disciplines the husband if he commits something wrong?
The society does.
This is the second question.
The question of permitting the husband to beat the wives has been taken up by me many a time before, but it requires a much bigger answer, more comprehensive answer than 1.5 minutes left for me would permit. Because I remember it would be justice.
Yes, yes,
only I tell you that people who beat in among the Muslims do not take license from the Quran. Where the Quran had permitted them or did not permit, they would beat. Those who are inclined towards beating, they don't take license from any religion. They do it because they are rotten people. Those who do not beat, do not start beating because the Holy Quran permits them. Recipient of the Quran, the Holy One, never beat his wives once, not once.
Okay, Hadur, I'll give him this short answer.
Inshallah, next time. Next time, we will take it up.
كان السؤال من الأخ أبو طالب يقول أن غير المسلمين يتهمون الإسلام بأنه يبيح للرجل أن يضرب زوجته. فمن الذي يؤدب الرجل إذا ارتكب خطأ في حق زوجته؟ أجاب أمير المؤمنين على الجزء الثاني من السؤال بأن المجتمع هو الذي يعاقب الرجل إذا اعتدى على زوجته بالضرب. أما فيما يتعلق بضرب الزوجات فإن أولئك الذين يضربون الزوجات لا يأخذون رخصة من القرآن ولا يسألون القرآن ولا يستسمحون في هذا، وإنما هي نفوسهم العليلة المريضة هي التي تدفعهم لضرب، وليس هناك من بدأ يضرب زوجته لأنه قرأها في القرآن. يقول أمير المؤمنين إن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الذي كان خلقه القرآن لم يضرب زوجة، هو لم يكن له زوجة واحدة، كان له أكثر من زوج، لم يضرب مرة واحدة إحدى زوجاته. فالذين يريدون أن يتعلموا من القرآن وتعاليم القرآن عليهم أن يتبعوا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم، لأنه أكثر إنسان فهم القرآن وطبقه على نفسه وعلى أسرته وعلى الآخرين. وقد وعد أمير المؤمنين أن يجيب على هذا السؤال بالتفصيل إن شاء الله في الحلقة القادمة.
Okay. I'll add a few more things. Once in response to this question here, I asked the questioner from England, who permits those drunkard people here who beat their wives on Monday so much and so many times and so many among them that in the entire year, in the entire world of Ahmadiyya, there are not one-tenth as many cases. You see, the whole year, whenever an Ahmadi husband does something to his wife which she doesn't like, she protests to me and writes to me immediately. So I'm monitoring what's happening all over the world. Hardly there are a few cases you can count on your fingertips, that's all. But watching a program here in England, a police officer told the audience and the viewers that in one day, thousands of British labourers and people belonging to that area who are drunkard, they return home and they beat their wives so mercilessly, and even the innocent children. This happens at far more in America, in New York, in the Harlem area and so on. So I inquired, did the Bible give them permission? Where did they get the permission from? Wanton people, rough people and criminal minded people would remain, they don't need a permission. So as far as the permission of the Quran is concerned,